Okay. So this was a great introduction into a focus of this session, which is security. And we are following up with a couple of presentations related to CERT and incident response. So the next one is Darko Perhots, welcome, from the Croatian CARNET National CERT, presenting Croatian National CERT. Darko, as previously, you have 20 minutes plus. We'll signal the time, okay. And then afterwards we have some questions. Thank you.
Okay, hello to everybody. I would like to introduce first myself. I'm Darko Perhoč. I'm Deputy Chief Executive Officer of Croatian Academic and Research Network and Head of National CERT. In this presentation, I will shortly present what activities we have in CERT, and also I will say something about ACDC project in which we are participating. This project is important, and it is co-financed by the European Commission. National CERT, our mission is promoting and preserving information security in public systems in Croatia. We have nine employees, including me, and for us are working two external co-workers. We were established in 2008 according with the law, Information Security Act. Also, 1996, in the past, was founded CARNET CERT, which was CERT, this CERT was predecessor of HR CERT, National CERT. This is the excerpt from Security Act, in which Chapter 5 says what is National CERT in Croatia and positions the National CERT into the main point as a point of contact on national level for reporting the incidents. Who are our constituency? Our constituency are all internet users in Croatia except government bodies. They have their CERT, which is positioned in security agency, another security agency. This means that we have a lot of contacts with ISPs, hosting providers, end users, and so on. What we do, we provide proactive measures and reactive measures. Proactive measures we provide in order to reduce the number of incidents, to reduce by warning people what they can do, what they should not do, and so on. We do this via our website, via our mailing lists, we provide vulnerability scans for our constituency, especially for CARNET, for institutions which are connected to CARNET network. As well, we are writing brochures about information security, which are usually distributed by daily newspapers in many issues. We issued four brochures up to date. They are focused to general users. They are not too technical, but they say what is important to internet users, how to be more safe on the internet. And last two, we're focused to privacy on Facebook and threats on Facebook. Of course, reactive measures are solving the incidents. We have one activity which is called today threat intelligence. We are gathering information about incidents which happen in Croatia. We process this information, and after that usually we inform compromised users about compromise. If necessary, we do some forensics of malware or network or JavaScript, HTML, and so on. What is our daily job? How we do this? Let's say in the night we wrote the software which connects to more than 20 feeds, gathers data about incidents. Then the software makes the deduplication and correlates all these events. If the software finds some IP addresses which are dynamically assigned, they are sent automatically by software to ISPs, and other stuff like malicious URLs and so on are delivered by mail to national cert, and then somebody from our workers analyzes the incident, puts the incident into ticketing system, solve the incident, and after that from the database we can draw some nice charts to see trends and to do some further analysis. These are incident types which are handled by national cert, denial of service, all kind of server compromise, of course client compromise, brute force attacks, phishing, internet frauds, any kind. Cooperation with other organization is regulated partly by the law. The law says what collaboration we have with these first two security agencies, but we have also signed memorandum of understanding with Ministry of Interior and Ministry of Defense, because in some cases, let's say, we are working together with police, of course. Also, we are the accredited member of FIRST and of TFC CERT working group. We have good cooperation with NISA and CERT EU. This is software which we've written for together the information about threats and incidents in Croatia. Daily, this software finds about 100,000 incident reports. Then the software extracts the data about Croatia, correlates this data. This was all this was shown on the picture before. These are graphs how looks trend last year of reported incidents related just for servers. This means that in some peaks, in some days, we have reported 40, 45, 30 compromised servers in our country. But all days there is something. There are no days when nothing happens. So this graph shows the trend of bots in Croatia. We started last year from 7,000, and now this number is slightly decreasing, and we finished last year with the number of about 4,000, and we had one peak in the middle of the year. This was a very massive Zeus infection which hits our country, and some companies from some companies the money was stolen. Okay. If we analyze which types of incidents are more represented, these are servers which distribute malware, phishing websites, and web defacements. These three compromises are the most often happen. What is the position of Croatia? You have globalsecuritymap.com. This is very nice service. You can find your country, the position, security position of your country. The Croatia is now on 184th place of 2009. And the last one is the most secure, let's say so. So this is good position, I think. Okay, and now a couple of words about ACDC project. ACDC is Advanced Cyber Defense Center. It is not the project with ACDC rock band. In this project participate 28 partners from 14 countries of European Union. Total cost of the project is 15.5 million euros, and co-financing of European Commission is 50%. This means that if you want to participate in such project, you should invest half of this money. At least 50% of the companies which participate are commercial, and another 50% are CERTs, academia, NRENs, and so on. What we did in this project, we were developing two types of honeypots for spam and for web attacks. We made some software for detection of fast flux domains, which are widely used by botnets. The goal of this project is to build EU-wide platform for detection and mitigation of the attacks by botnets. And this is very rough picture how this platform should look like. Every partner participating, in fact, 24 partners of 28, have some tools, their own tools. And in this project, we had to connect all these tools to one exchange point, which is, the name is of this point is Central Clearinghouse. Which is placed now in DAT6 in Germany. And all partners sent the data about botnets detected in their countries in real time to this central clearinghouse. So as well now in this stage of the project, we are able to read also the data for our country from other partners. This means that we receive in national cert every day the data for Croatia, which is detected by other partners. On the left side, upper side, there are two portals. One portal is for key management, because you should have key, authenticate yourself to send or receive data from Central Clearinghouse. And another portal is the portal of National Support Center. The goal of this portal is to provide end users with a lot of tools which are commercial or free for cleansing their workstations, or to scan their workstations and so on. This is how look some reports which are sent to Germany. Let's say we are scanning spams which are received by spam trap, because spams are usually containing URLs which point to malicious websites. So we sent to Central Clearing House such websites and which we detect in spams. Also, all URLs from which our honeypot is attacked, we also sent to Central Clearing House. At this moment, we have in Croatia about 10 sensors installed. Two are in Portugal and in Bulgaria. And all these sensors send data first to correlation server, which is also in Croatia. There is the intelligence in this correlation server. And after that, the data is sent to Central Clearing House. These are collected fast flux domains. we have installed two sensors. One is in Carnet network and another is in the network of Croatian Telecom. These sensors are placed between DNS recursor and authoritative DNS, and these sensors are sniffing DNS traffic. This data is sent to correlation server, which detects fast flux domains. And of course, these domains are sent as detected to Central Clearing House. This is the index page of of National Support Center, which provides the end users with all these tools and some information about botnets. And that's it. Thank you for your attention. Questions, if somebody have.
Very rich presentation. Thank you. So if there are any questions for Darko, seeming you've been perfectly clear about everything.
Everything
you said.
Is perfectly clear.
there's one, sorry, wait.
Now I'm using the wildcard. What is the relation of the CERT with the, you said you have a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of Interior and MOD. What's generally the relation, how does it work? Including the secret services, which is probably also an important part when it comes to communication. How does it work? Is there understanding? Is it simply a clear procedure how it works?
It is a quite clear procedure. if there are some cases and Ministry of Interior needs some additional expertise, let's say for Linux and something like that, they can ask us to make some forensics. But we never know the whole story, just this technical detail. So.
Okay, well, I think we have no more questions, but you can certainly, you're going to be here around in the afternoon if people wish to speak to you over a coffee break. So thank you very much.